conditions really were atrocious yesterday. Driving rain, which obviously made for a heavy pitch. But at least the Everton fans gave a warm reception to one of their former heroes, Andy King, who was making his debut for West Brom. Your commentator is Martin Tyler.
There's a different look to Everton's midfield today because of a hamstring injury to Alan Ainsworth. Steve McMahon is recalled, which means that Trevor Ross is switched to a wider role. And Eamon O'Keefe, who scored as a substitute in midweek against Notts County, now plays from the start in place of Peter Eastow, who hasn't shaken off a Friday morning training injury. Albion's problems are in the centre of their defence, with both John Wilde's natural partners, Alistair Robertson and Martin Bennett, unfit. So Brian Robson takes on that role after missing two games with a bruised foot. Gary Owen is also fit again, and there's also a place for 20-year-old Nicky Cross. There's been so much rain, in fact, that the referee asked for the pitch lines to be remarked shortly before the kickoff. West Bromwich Albion in this first half defending the goal to our left, looking to end a run of four games without a goal. Again, the target dropped for Steve McMahon. McKenzie for Andy King. Here's Cross. Starting a new game for only the second time. Playing the 1-2 with King. And Nicky Cross going on. And good handling from Jim Arnold. Greasy conditions helping goalkeepers as Cross swept it in. Touch from McMahon as he was being held by John Wilde. Here's Lyons driving forward. Well, it drew an ooh from the crowd. I don't think Tony Godden was too worried. Is passing over the Albion bar. Touch from McMahon as he was being held by John Wilde. Here's Lyons driving forward. Well, it drew an ooh from the crowd. I don't think Tony Godden was too worried. Always passing over the Albion bar. Now Ross. Thomas calling for it and getting it. Leaving David Mills. Biley's gone to the near post and it's Biley with the spectacular effort. Alan Biley at the moment looking to recapture the impact that he made in the opening two games of the season for Everton when he scored both those games. Mickey Thomas picking him out well here. Just hooked wide. Is he quick to close down Hartford when he's in possession? And King doing the same. Here's Cross. And it's Mills meeting it. And the flag was up. David Mills got ahead of his marker. Scored a penalty on the opening day of the season, but clearly hasn't recaptured the scoring form he showed at Middlesbrough. Now Ratcliffe. And Biley. A deep cross from Kevin Ratcliffe and a clean jump from Biley. So the two Everton attempts in the first 25 minutes of any consequence have both come from Alan Biley. Mills doing well to ease it on here for Cross. And it deflects off Walsh. And so close to deflecting inside that near post. Cross was content really just to drive it across as a shot come ball into the path of Regis, who was arriving. Just a back flick from Regis, and almost made something for Mills. King going on, Andy King for David Mills, and again Albion faulted by an offside call. But Andy King, just for a moment, working himself into a position where perhaps a debut goal against his old club was on the cards, opted instead to reverse it inside for Mills. Curled in by Thomas. Godson's punch was solid. Thomas again. O'Keefe, good goalkeeping. Looking to keep up the impetus with Walsh. O'Keefe, time to stay them. But it was Eamon O'Keefe a moment or two earlier whose little flick header there produced good reflexes from Tony Godden. But before the corner can be used to any profit, the half-time whistle goes. Goalless first half in which there has been much to admire in Albion's work in midfield, where Andy King has settled in well. But a rather disjointed first 45 minutes from Everton. Half time at Goodison Park, Everton 0, West Bromwich Albion 0. In the second half, we expect Everton to hope to create more from the middle of the field. Albion. Regis lets it run, and Mills onside, in against Arnold, and the goalkeeper comes out on top, and it's driven back by Owen. Another opportunity passes West Bromwich Albion by. Everton will feel that Mills was offside in the first place, but the flag stayed down. Albion have gone so long without a goal seems to play a part in David Mills' mind. He wanted to make sure. Mills could drop for him again, and Arnold getting his body behind it, although the handling was totally clean. David Mills wasting no time as the ball dropped for him, snatching the shot. Caught by Robson and reacted angrily to the tackle. And here's Batson. Regis' shot, the chance for Owen, it's in the net and it's offside. West Bromwich Albion must wonder what they've got to do to get a goal chalked up. Mills played it in, Batson kept running, watched Regis arrive here, comes off Arnold, Owen plants it in, but an offside decision says it doesn't count. Jim Arnold didn't escape the legacy of that collision with Cyril Regis, although he can smile about it. Kendall has come down from his seat in the stand. One wonders whether he was thinking of changing the Everton pattern anyway with the introduction of McBride. As Everton now look to make their substitution. Steve McMahon being called off to be replaced by Joe McBride. Ball. Lyons scores. some time in this game to have something to cheer about. But Mick Lyons provides it. The flip free kick, Lyons ducking his head, getting in first, and it ends up in the back of the net. Played in the second half. And now Albion have a free kick in an almost identical position. John Wilde diving in. Wilde, who was the player running with Lyons as Albion conceded the goal, to redress the situation. The corner entrusted to Ross. Right. So close. A back flick from Billy Wright. Of Thomas. Everton with this back flick from Billy Wright, thwarted by fine work from Godden and the crossbar. Thomas with a touch. Statham playing it straight to Ross as he gifted it. Well, it won't count. Bailey was in an offside position. How relieved Derek Statham will be. Here with nowhere to go. But you look at the position there of Alan Bailey. Just checking as Wilde makes his way forward again. This is Mills. Ross. And it's O'Keefe against Batson. In acres of space on the far side. Batson still doing the covering, and McBride so close to a spectacular goal on the break, and McBride has it again from a poor clearance by Godden, and Bailey turns it wide and appeals for a corner. Everton breaking initially here with O'Keefe, showing good vision. McBride opting, as he saw Batson coming across, to try the shot. Too long, and the Everton supporters salute a victory provided by one of the club's most loyal servants, Mick Lyons. Header in the end, the difference between the two sides. Everton still really short of the consistency that Howard Kendall will demand, and as for West Bromwich Albion, they must trudge off to the dressing room, having now gone 7.5 hours of football without a goal.
Yes, and but for some poor finishing, Albion might well have taken the points. It was an Everton performance that largely disappointed their manager, Howard Kendall, but he admitted afterwards that it was partly his own fault.
I think I selected the wrong side. I think I probably should have started with Joey McBride. With losing Alan Ainscoe with an injury, I selected a midfield, which was probably logical on the day, and then, having thought about it and having seen what happened in the first half especially, we lacked someone wide who could go past.
What was your verdict apart from that?
Disappointing the first half, but the second half, the goal relaxed everyone. Tremendous goal, and that relaxed everyone. We started to play, and then it turned out quite exciting near the end. We could have had a couple more, I thought.
Are you pleased with the style of football they're serving up?
I think it can be improved, yeah, and that's what we're looking to do. I'm aware that everyone wants to see style here as well as results, and we'll try and provide that. As I say, I thought that when Joey came on, he gave us that width and he looked as if he was going past. Alan Ainscoe's given us that up to now. So really, it was down to me the first 45, I think, that, you know, I should have started with that.